People in America and all over the world, greetings to you all. Paul Muckler here. Today is July 14, 2011 at 12 p.m. Eastern Time. I was in the process of making a video, right, to show you guys a UFO that I spotted 2 days ago. I think the 11th or the 12th, and to show you all a hexagram around this star right here. You see the star you're looking at? NASA says it's Venus, but there's a hexagram around it. But and you know about the hexagram around Saturn. But while I'm making this video, right, people, I listened to the news and I heard them talking about, you know, the credit rating agencies, Moody and S&P. I heard the headline saying Moody raised downgrading U.S. credit rating, and S&P threatened to cut U.S. credit rating. People, especially those in America, do you hear what I just said? Moody and S&P, they are threatening to downgrade the United States credit rating. Now, people of America, let me show y'all now how y'all been taken for fools, for total idiots. Is your country in a recession right now? Yes, it is. It's in a recession. Why is your country in a recession? Because of mortgages that was originated in America from 2001 to 2008. And those mortgages have securities attached to them. Now, securities are like stocks that you invest in these mortgages, and when the people pay their mortgages, when they pay the interest rate is it's split up to the shareholders, because the certificate buyers, it's like they're paying the bank in advance for the mortgage. The banks are getting paid in full for the loans. They're getting all their money back. And when the interest rate comes in the mortgages, the people who buy the securities, they get money out of the interest rate plus interest. Now, people who, now in order for these securities to sell, they have to be graded. And if they're graded AAA, it means that they're like hot potatoes. Everybody want to buy AAA mortgages. Now, people who graded those mortgages as AAA. People know, we know America economy fell based on falsification of the rating of mortgages. The mortgages were rated AAA when they were not, because all the loans were fraudulent. The banks falsified people's income. Everyone, over 10 million homeowners, 60 million, over 60 million homeowners, okay, they falsify the credit ratings so they could sell the securities to people all over the world. Now, people who rated these mortgages, who rated the securities at AAA? Who, people? Moody, S&P, and I don't remember the rest of my head, but all these credit rating agencies were involved in rating these securities at AAA when they know they were worthless. Now, people, here's proof that these banks control America and it's threatening your government. The same people who rated shitty mortgages at AAA knowingly and intentionally to collapse the economy, it's the same people that are now threatening to downgrade the United States economy if America doesn't get a credit increase. So they destroy the economy, force you to do bailout, then demanding that you increase your credit rating. The same people. It's a game. So, now, hear this now. in before George Bush left office. He used your taxpayer money to bail out Wall Street. Now, where did he get this money from? From Social Security, from entitlements. They raided the coffers, they raided the treasury of the entitlement benefits, raided it, and gave it to who? To the banks for losses of these same mortgages. Then when Mr. Obama came into office, he did the top also. He continued the Bush bailouts. So they took the money out of the coffers, the entitlement money, took that money and gave it to these banks that these credit rating agencies helped to help to rob us. Okay? They took that money, so what this credit rating agency did, they was with the banks, okay, that did the shitty mortgages. So now they got the banks to give you bailout. So now that the America is broke now. And so America took all their money, gave it to these banks, and the banks are just sitting down on the money and not spending it. Just sitting on the money and not spending it. And telling you to take out a loan. You gave them money. You gave them $750 billion, but they won't give you a loan. And all you want is $736 billion. So, this same credit rating agency that brought America to its knees are the same ones saying, give us more credit. Take out more credit. Take out more credit. We're gonna downgrade your credit rating. And then the Republicans actually say, oh, we're not gonna raise the debt ceiling. But how is America going to survive if you don't raise taxes? You can't raise the debt ceiling, so you have to raise taxes. You have no choice. You have to raise taxes on the riches. But no, don't raise taxes on the riches. So you see, people, it's a game. It's a stalemate. It's a stalemate. They are creating stalemates purposely. The Democrats and the Republicans, they are in this together. It's a freaking game. And you Americans, you all are the pawns. People, when it's all said and done, America going to realize one day that they are, that the, even though they think that they are the freest nation on earth and the most intelligent, you are going to find that American, I don't mean to disrespect. I don't mean to disrespect, but when it comes to the end, you're going to find that you are the dumbest and the most enslaved people on planet earth. You're not the freest and you're not the wisest. You are very intelligent. Yes, America, you are very intelligent. When it comes to worldly things, you are very intelligent. When it comes to your temporal salvation and your spiritual salvation, you are the dumbest. You are at the bottom of the pack. Because the government, they're giving you candy and honey while they're sticking wooden in your butts. I won't even say it. Wooden stuff in you. Okay? That's what they're doing to you. So, the point being is that these people are playing games with you. They are in it together. And you Republicans will think that don't raise the debt ceiling. You think it's a good thing? And you who saying don't cut taxes, you think you're doing a good, don't raise taxes, you think you're doing a good thing? It's a game. You have no choice but to raise the debt ceiling. No choice. Either raise it or declare the national debt is paid. That's it. But why raise the debt ceiling? Why not just raise taxes instead? Raise taxes on the rich. You don't have to raise the debt ceiling. You don't have to cut no entitlement. Just freaking raise taxes on the rich. Take back all tax money from them. So Americans, I'm sorry, but you all are at the bottom. When it comes to wisdom, when it comes to intelligence, you are at the top. When it comes to wisdom, you're at the bottom. I am so sad to say that. One love. What are we gonna do?
Just in time, huh? Yes, I hear you. I hear you. Strike the hammer while the fire is hot.
God.
Yes, my lord. Yes, my lord. Hit them. That one scared the hell out of me.